Today I'm going to explore the inner workings of Aibo, a robotic pet that Sony first introduced in 1999, and ask the question, does Aibo have a soul? Back in 1997, images of Sony prototype robots began appearing. Sony was developing a robot in their digital creatures lab. By 1999, Sony had released their first robot called Aibo, which sold out immediately. By immediately, I mean the first batch sold out online in 20 minutes. The second batch, a few months later, sold out in 17 seconds. This was at a time when selling anything online was quite unusual. The following year, with everything they learned from that first model, Sony released the second generation Aibo with many enhancements, including new features such as voice recognition and a PC card slot for Wi-Fi networking expansion. I have here one of these second generation models. Another aspect unique to this model is the modular design. By using a tool to access the release mechanisms, the legs, head, and tail can all be removed. The designers even went to the trouble of putting spring-loaded covers over the contacts. Here in Aibo's behind is the card slot. The Aibo branded Wi-Fi card was quite an expensive add-on, and while I don't have one, as it turns out, there is also a Veo branded Wi-Fi card that is compatible and much less expensive. This will help us connect to Aibo remotely and give us an insight into how this Aibo perceives the world. Now we need to add software. Aibo uses special Sony memory sticks. They typically come in pink to indicate they are specially designed for Aibo, and include hidden sectors to prevent making copies onto other memory sticks. To start Aibo, we press the chess button and Aibo begins the boot process. Aibo plays various tunes depending on the software loaded. The software I'm booting up here is called Aibo Life, which can take over a minute to boot. This is one of the more sophisticated learning and growing personalities. After boot, there is a leg stretch. Aibo has a video camera for vision, infrared distance sensor, stereo microphones for voice commands, and sound direction. Being a robot, Aibo communicates primarily through movement, but also sounds, melodies, and face lights, and, in this model, a tail light. These express what Aibo is feeling in the Aibo Life neural network-based personality software. Let's now have a peek inside Aibo's vision system and see through the eyes of this robot. Aibo comes with a pink ball. Here we can see the ball tracking as Aibo's head moves around to keep the ball in sight. I am connecting directly to Aibo over Wi-Fi and running software on this computer called AiboScope from aibohack.com. With everything connected, we start to get a view of what Aibo sees. Next to the main view are processed images, including color separation and high contrast views. This gives us an impression of how Aibo can see the ball against most backgrounds and lighting conditions. Now let's watch as Aibo plays with the pink ball. Not a good first kick, Aibo. How about trying again? That's better. How about one more time? Let's have a look at other sections in AiboScope. We will now hear through Aibo's ears and compare that to the voice commands being processed. Aibo, come here. Come here, Aibo. Stand up. Aibo actually following these commands depends on what Aibo is doing and the mood the robot is in at the time. There is also a radar section. This gives us an idea of the direction of things in 3D space that Aibo knows about, displayed in AiboScope from a rear and top-down view. To the right are some controls for the camera and microphone settings. The box at the bottom is the event log with details of everything Aibo is doing. Now it's time to start changing Aibo's personality and software settings. First, another AiboHack program called AiboTool, running on a Sony Clio. This allows some mods to Aibo, including general behavior modes, current personality states, and things like color preferences and automatic wake-up time. Sony also released programming tools for making your own custom personalities. There are also some great third-party tools for custom personalities. One great site is DogsBodyNet.com, with lots of reference materials and tools, including a telnet-based system for programming Aibo while in operation. DogsBodyNet also provide one of the most popular and free personalities called DogsLife. Later versions of Aibo software introduce the self-docking feature. When Aibo's battery is running low, Aibo searches for the charging base using the pink ball and certain colours as a reference, and goes and sits down to recharge. I have some of that later software running here, again with AiboScope, so we can see Aibo doing the docking procedure. Free DogsLife personality can also do self-docking, however, it doesn't work with AiboScope, so I'm using some software here which includes an annoying voice. Later models of Aibo greatly improve the self-docking feature. In the introduction, I raised the question, does Aibo have a soul? Assuming you haven't dismissed this question as the insane ponderings of someone who befriends robots.
You really want a robot for a friend?
Yeah, ever since I was six.
Then consider the work of Christine Sunu, an emotive robotics expert who did a Hackaday talk about how robots can make us feel. She describes another talk she gave in which she demonstrated a furry robot and the reaction of the audience when she snapped the robot in two, which was quite shocking. With some Aibos now reaching 20 years old, we have started to see many pass away and funerals held at Buddhist temples in Japan so people can say goodbye to the pets that were part of their family. So it seems Aibo does indeed have an electromechanical soul. After a 12-year absence, Aibo has been reborn, with Sony reintroducing a new model of Aibo. Living with Aibo is nothing like a biological pet. It's a very different yet amazing experience.